So growing up here in Ala Valley, there's a lot of aerospace and flight research. We would have sonic booms all the time. We get all kinds of cool fighter jets flying overhead. The B-2 bomber would, you know, be flying over.
To line him up for Edwards runway.
One of the most unique things, though, was whenever the space shuttle would land here, and it had this trademark double sonic boom. And that's something that I would never forget.
Two sonic booms signaling its arrival at the California coast.
And just the thought that, wow, the space shuttle came from space, and it's landing right here in our own backyard. And so that's a memory that I'll never forget, is how cool it is being in this area with all the flight research going on. Space shuttle landed here, and I'm excited for the future because this is a really unique spot. So that this would be Flutter, that would be Flutter, and then because it has different tabs. So I went to Cal Poly in San Luis Obispo, and I graduated with a double major in physics and aerospace engineering, and I also got my master's in aerospace engineering. So growing up, education was extremely important in my family. It was almost like not a question about not doing well. It was very much expected that I was supposed to do well. My parents, I think they just did a great job where I didn't feel pressured. I felt more internally that I really had high expectations for myself.
Hey, Wesley.
I'm Alex Chin. I'm an aerospace engineer at NASA Armstrong. I work in the Aerostructures group at NASA Armstrong Flight Research Center, and I do research in structural dynamics, which means that we study the phenomena of the forces acting on a structure during motion. One of the biggest pushes that NASA Aeronautics is working on right now is in green aviation. So in green aviation, we're trying to look at, okay, how can we make flight more efficient? One of the best ways is, well, why don't we just make the aircraft lighter? But by making it lighter, we're looking at the wings becoming, you know, more longer, more flexible. And yes, we get better efficiencies, but then we get all these structural dynamic consequences. So what we're working on right here is the X-56A.
Ready for takeoff? Structures?
Structures is ready.
System?
And we're trying to actually actively suppress flutter and flight.
Ready for your calls.
Airborne.
Let's take off Liquid 18.
So that means is that, okay, we're going to keep the flexible wings. We're going to still have them in the flight envelope. But what if we can use, you know, our existing control flaps to actually suppress flutter? Instead of saying, okay, we don't want our wing to twist because that we don't understand that, that could be a bad thing. What if we intentionally twist the wing to try and get, you know, better flight dynamics? Well, originally we thought, okay, we're designing that out. We have to reconsider it. And instead of trying to avoid these problems, we want to exploit it. So turning a bad guy into a good guy is what we're trying to do.
Stay on condition.
160 select.
Selected.
Clear start.
Starting. Mark.
Yeah, pitch down, up, one overshoot, and back.
So one of the cool things about working at NASA Armstrong Flight Research Center that keeps me coming back every day is seeing how the projects you worked on, you see it start from concept all the way to flight. A lot of times you only look at one certain part of a test program. You become the expert in doing this type of analysis, but then you never actually see the aircraft or flight article that you're working on. So it's a great experience working out here that you do an analysis, you work with the vehicle, you staff the control room, you're right there with the crew briefs, you work with the pilots, you see a program from beginning to end, and it really helps bring a strong appreciation for what goes on into the life cycle of a program. And I think it's a really unique experience working out here at Armstrong.